From the class P, we now turn to the class NP. At the beginning of the lesson, I said that NP is the class of problems verifiable in polynomial time. This is true, but it's not how we typically define it. Instead, we define NP as the class of problems solvable in polynomial time on a non-deterministic Turing machine, a variant that we haven't encountered before. Non-determinism in computer science is often misunderstood, so put aside whatever associations you might have had with the word.
Perhaps the best way to understand non-deterministic Turing machines is by contrasting a non-deterministic computation with a deterministic one. A deterministic computation starts in some initial state, and then the next state is exactly and uniquely determined by the transition function. There's only one possible successor configuration, and to that configuration, there's only one possible successor, and so on and so forth, until an accepting or rejecting configuration is reached, if one is reached at all. On the other hand, in a non-deterministic computation, we start in a single initial configuration, but it's possible for there to be multiple successor configurations. In effect, the machine is able to explore multiple possibilities at once. This potential splitting continues at every step. Sometimes there might just be one possible successor state, sometimes there might be three or more. For each branch, we have all the same possibilities as for a deterministic machine. The machine can reject, it can loop forever, or it can accept. If the machine ever accepts in any of these branches, then the whole machine accepts. The only change to the seven-tuple definition of the deterministic machine that we need to make is to modify the transition function. The range is no longer a single state, tape symbol being read, direction tuple, but a whole collection of such possibilities. The set of all subsets is often called a power set. The only other change we need to make is when the machine accepts. It accepts if there is any valid sequence of configuration that results in an accepting state. Naturally, it also rejects only when every branch reaches a reject state. If there's a branch that hasn't rejected yet, then we need to keep computing in case it accepts. Therefore, a non-deterministic machine that never accepts and that loops on at least one branch will loop.